Paladin's been back another action. This time we're going in with someone I'm scared of because everyone is saying that this is going to be a wild ride. Nicole DeLanginger, I think. I had to Google how to pronounce it. So many artists, I just cannot say names. I don't even know how they say their names. I'm just not very good at English, clearly. Her album, Natural Born Losers, I put it up. I said, which one do I need to start with? And this one got the most votes. So if it's your favorite, here we are. If it's not, well, if I vibe with this, I'll go in with her other ones and, you know, see where we go with their discography. Album cover looks scary. She's got this little bloody leather mask on, so that's already creeping me out, with some like lavender flower background. I mean, it looks like it's made on Microsoft Paint or something like that, so I don't know how. Like, I think we're gonna get like quite indie vibes. I have no idea what she sounds like. I've never heard of her. She's just been requested a heap of times. I was like, right, I just need to get onto it. I need to give you guys what you want, like always. I mean, I just deliver the goods. I mean, yeah, nothing else to say. I don't know. I don't know anything. I don't know anything. What's new? Let's just get straight into it. The opening song is called Poacher's Pride. Let's go. Gave me no time to even just get into it. I think just not having an intro really threw me. I wasn't expecting her to go straight into it, and then the lyrics from the get-go were already like, what the hell is going on? I mean, yeah, I loved it. I just wish it kind of had a bit of an intro. I mean, even the end, it's just, all right, bye, see ya. So quick. Yeah, 2 minute song, so impacting. I'm like, what the hell, you psycho little chick? Killing an angel, taxidermy, in your basement, starving it, whatever else you did. Alright, so we're gonna be in for a bloody whirlwind here. I don't know what to expect anymore. I'm so caught off guard. I just feel like on edge. I just don't feel like I'm like here yet. So I need to just like absorb it. Really cool. I love the instruments. I love the guitar. That indie little vibe with her creepy little angelic voice, but then these melodic, bloody, creepy lyrics. Alright, the next song is called Mean. Let's go. Oh, needs to stop with this bloody... These transitions are too volatile. They're so full on. I'm still... What are two songs that we've heard? Oh my God. This is already so full on. I cannot get over just how quick and stop these... Just how quick these are stopping and starting. The lyrics are insane. The music is just perfection. It's absolutely my vibe in terms of production, but she's just twisting it and really doing some stuff to it. It's so like indie little cute vibes and with her beautiful voice over it. And then these lyrics are just so full on. You guys are all so messed up for making me react to this, because this is just, yeah, it's definitely giving me Ethel Kane vibe, but just so different. What a song though. Like, what's this? Sister, bride, angel, slave, like, who is that person she's singing about? Any information that you know, obviously let me know down below. Yeah, I'm keen to see where this is gonna go. Insane. The next song is called White Trashing, which is, I don't know, bizarre. Is it just about like white trash or like, you know, bogans or whatever? Let's go. See, like, she tricks you with this nice cute stuff. You just got within that. I just had this like old house, like with a veranda, her with this dude, like just white trash is obviously what it's about, and just this quintessential image that you just see in so many images, like, you know, drug induced and all that kind of stuff. Yeah, whoa, heavy, like simply delivered, just said so effortlessly, but such vivid pictures you get with the lyrics that she's singing about. Production incredible. I mean, I'm probably gonna say that in every song. Just the delivery is so flawless and perfect, and just so capturing of, yeah, images within your head, and then you just think about how that person's life could be, and that's what kind of, you're like, whoa, this is just intense. Oh, I'm like nervous to see where this album is gonna go, but I'm also excited to see where it goes. Next song is called Swan. Let's go. How are these short songs so hitting and impactful? It really just makes me appreciate it even more, because how many artists are releasing such short songs now and they're just shit? Like, this is just, yeah, it was 2.5 minutes, and the story, again, all the images she's conjuring, the lyrics are so great, so amazing, so perfect, accompanied with the amazing sound. It's just so hitting and just so full on, and I love the storyline we're kind of getting now. Like, just kind of, yeah, it definitely feels like there's a lot of issues with her dad or a partner, or, you know, men in general. I mean, oh no, it could be anyone. That's, I guess, the first thing that I'm thinking. That poor swan, though. So sad. Like, the poor little thing. The next song is called In the Land. Let's go. I don't know if I got it right with what I kind of thought it sounded like, but again, just the images I was getting, like, I pictured this caravan, I pictured the kitchen, pictured the roadside. What an artist this chickadee is. Oh my God, I can't get over these lyrics and the sound and just how they all morph together. And it's so, you just want to keep listening. You just can't believe what you're hearing, but also you can believe it because that happens in the world. And I guess that's even more intense and just shocking. Like, these just sound like real life situations that happen all the time, which is even sadder. Incredible, incredible. Incredible. When she spoke about that milk carton, I thought it was like a missing person on the milk carton, but then the mum's like force feeding her or something weird. I don't know. Just let me know everything about these songs, because it's insane. Number 6 is here. My favorite number. Is it going to give us the best song of the album? It's called Alligator Blood. I'm so scared now what we're going to get. Let's go. The music underneath. a song, one of the best just in terms of lyrical content and just the production. So underrated, just how that was there. It didn't actually really do much, but it did. It was just this constant like, yeah. The way her voice just reflects so many different styles of music and just the way it's incorporated is absolutely, I can't get over it. It's absolutely incredible. It's nothing like I've ever heard. I mean, that was like a rocky kind of vibe, but just suited that scene. Oh my God, scene, like story. True Blood kind of vibes in terms of like the aesthetic of what I was picturing. I don't know, this cannot be about her real life childhood, right? This has got to be metaphors and things like that. I mean, that one's definitely about like, you know, boys will be boys, toughen up, you know, that hard love kind of approach. I don't know. This is just insane and just so beautiful, but so disturbing and so messed up and so wrong on so many levels, but you just so taken aback by it and you're just so captivated. Incredible. The next song is called Executioner. I'm scared. Let's go. So now is that dude dead? I love how she says you'll cry out for your father, and that's just, I guess, this toxic masculinity vibe, how men don't treat their sons or allow them to be emotional so then they become being fucking freaks. Well, I think there's some science behind it with like this light, they think you admit the light or something like that. So I think it's really clever how she's obviously probably looked up executions and things like that. Whoa, just insane lyrical content, insane topics. I love it, so good. The next song is called American Tradition. I'm keen for this, just how this is absolutely encapsulated quintessential American vibes. I've loved the whole way. I just haven't said it out loud. Now this song has said it, I'm like, that's what I'm feeling. And just that everybody fries in Texas. Oh my God. All right, this song, let's go. Least favorite, just I guess the weirdest, but not the weirdest in terms of actual weird, because we've had much weirder songs. I guess just not where I thought it was gonna go, so maybe I just went in with high expectations. I guess it still kind of just shows America's just so weird when you really analyze the things they do and just their culture and like how people move away to go to school and college and all that stuff. It's just so bizarre and it's so quintessential, this thing that we all just know about because it's you know, just everywhere. Yeah, like, he's a hockey player, she's a skater figure, and I guess their life didn't plan out the way they wanted, now they're, like, white trash poor. I don't know. Just such a weird one, that one. Beautiful production, beautiful instruments. Just, yeah, I guess the weirdest to interpret, but not. I don't know. The weirdest for me in terms of what weird is in comparison to this album. The next song is called Angels of Porn 2. I don't know where one is, but we're going in with two. Let's go. Fools have come extracted from everyone. What? I need the explanation, please, because I don't know what that's about. Yeah, that's that. Far out. The next song is called A Marvelous Persona. Let's go. I still can't get over the last song. Sounds nice and tranquil, though. Tranquil. Oh, yes, the rain. Give me a storm. That sounds so good from a little olden day movie. So cute. Stunning little piece, little interlude. I love the music, I love the storm, I love the rain, I love the little movie dialogue being put in there. That was so cute. I want a whole album just with that little vibe. Oh my god. With the last song of this album, it's called You're So Cool, which is the weirdest title. And when I say weird now, it actually doesn't make, it's just the most normal. It's the funny, it's like weird is now normal, but it's weird to be normal on this album. You're So Cool. Let's go. You're so cool. Thank you. interesting kind of like back half. I think from American tradition onwards, I kind of just didn't really connect with it as much. Not that I could, I guess I could connect with the first half just in terms of lyrical content. There was some hitting things in there that you could still relate to. American tradition really threw me, and I guess it was a bit more like, what's the right word? Like just a bit more generic in terms of it wasn't so graphic and descriptive. So I guess your mind could wander a bit more. So maybe that's why I kind of could escape. I could explore things. Whereas the other songs were just so in your face. So this is what's happening. You were just like, oh my God. American tradition, Angel of the Poem was just weird to me. I loved A Marvelous Persona, so I don't really count that one. Just these last three. Even this You're So Cool. Is it about that American jock who's got all this pressure on him? And, you know, I don't know. I'd love to know what it's about. Let me know down below. Also written, which is insane. I don't know how much of the producing she does. I'm going to guess she has quite a lot of an input. She seems like this very artistic, creative chick. It's her fifth album, which is insane because I'm like, what else has she been singing about before this album? Not that it sounds like a debut album at all. I'm just like, oh my God, just with everything she's saying, you'd think this would be something quite early on in her career, but it's not. So I'm like, what on earth? How is this album so good considering it's like her sixth one or fifth one, whatever I just said. I'm like, I don't even know. Very weird album cover, but I guess it really suits so much of the lyrical content. Got bloody birds crowing out there. Alligator Blood, absolutely insane. Poacher's Pride, I love how she referenced it. That just really caught me off guard. Meme was insane. White Trash and Swan. Oh yeah. The first seven, absolutely incredible. So graphic, so lyrical based, so incredible. The music on every single song was flawless, perfection. Like I said, I don't think I've heard anything like this recently or at all, just where it's so its own thing. And the lyrics, they could be so disjointed on another artist, but she just manages to mesh them together and make it sound so good. Yeah, I can't wait to listen to it again. I definitely want to listen to this. It's got those quintessential American vibes that I love. It's just got beautiful little indie production, psychotic lyrics that just make you think. Visions thread through your mind. Incredible. Oh, wow. Let me know everything down below. Oh my God. I need information. You guys are psycho for listening to this stuff. I love her though. So thanks for letting me know about it. Thanks for handing me to get onto her. Thanks for voting for this one because this is the best introduction, I think, to her. Well, it's the only one I know. Super biased there, but I don't know. I just really love this album. It gave me everything that I love about music. So obviously you guys know what I like. Yeah, all the vibes that I just said. So yeah, the full uncut, that is on Patreon. Link is down below if you want to check that out. Hit like and subscribe if you want to see more of me. Let me know if you want more of Nicole, Nikki babe. I'm on Instagram, regrouping. Hope you're having a great interview. I'm going to have a great interview. Ben is going to go.